When we substitute a threat for an argument, violence for principle, we allow our passion to overcome our capacity for reason. Passion and self-interest are threats to liberty, which brings us to Bowers against Hardwick. A police officer entered Mr. Hardwick's apartment, ostensibly to serve him with a warrant for an unpaid violation for drinking in public. They caught him with an open bottle of beer. When he entered Mr. Hardwick's bedroom, he coincidentally found him in bed with another man. The officer arrested Hardwick for violating Georgia's statute which outlaws sodomy. Now, even though Georgia dropped the case, Hardwick brought suit to challenge the constitutionality of the statute. Now, what was his claim?
Yeah. That it violates his right of privacy.
Why?
Because it's Hardwick's home. He's got a right to do as he pleases there.
But what if he decided to sell drugs at his home or engage in child abuse in his home? Yeah.
Because those actions don't fit within the right of privacy. The court, beginning with Griswold, has limited the right of privacy to actions which are intimate, which are deeply personal, actions which allow us to control our lives, to define who we are.
Yeah, but how is that a constitutional claim? There's no right to define oneself written into the Constitution. There's not even a right of privacy in the Bill of Rights.
If the state of Georgia can regulate Hardwick's sexuality engaged in private with consenting adults, Hardwick cannot be free. The Constitution was written to ensure limited government. If there's no right of privacy, if Georgia can enforce the statute, we sacrifice the liberty the framers thought they guaranteed us.
Well, the Supreme Court disagreed with you, Ms. Shaw. They found that the statute did not violate the right of privacy. Now, why is that?
Because they're wrong.